Now, here are Kelly Ripa and Josh Groban.
Peoples.
It is June 21st, 2012. My co-host for today is backed by popular demand, Josh Groban. Josh.
I got you.
Josh wrote me the most incredible song backstage. Josh, sing it. Sing it for
well,
the people.
Well, we were talking about how, you know, I think it was a Twitter trending topic at one point. This dress has sparked
the
lots
miracle
of,
dress,
of
yes.
controversy.
Yes.
Controversy and interest. And for a number of reasons, but you actually, I have to say, co-wrote this song with me.
I did co-write this song.
And it goes, nipple, 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 no, it's a seam. Because it's not a nipple. It's
just a seam.
It's just a seam.
It's just a seam.
Isn't that the twist at the end?
It's so great.
Yeah.
That was. And you make sure you look for that on iTunes.
On iTunes. That is available right
now. That'll be out right now. Momentarily,
that's
it will
how
be
we
out.
Do. That's how we do.
So we always talk about these traveling stories on our show.
Yeah.
And a poll reveals that the most popular airline seat, if you're flying home today, the most popular airline seat concluded that 6A, based on window seat preferences, its positioning toward the front of the aircraft, was the most preferred seat by flyers. The least popular seat, and I'm sorry if you're ticket holders, of 31E is the least popular seat.
Damn it.
It's very noisy. They usually run out of food, and they can't recline.
Is 31 the back of that particular plane? Is that like the...
They're just saying in general. They're
in
just
general.
In general.
In general.
31E is
31E
typically
stinks.
The least requested seat on the plane.
That's amazing.
People
that'll
try
be,
to get out of 31E.
Well, I have a pet peeve, and that is just in any row being stuck in the middle seat. There's a whole article about it in Business Travel about being trapped in the middle seat. I've talked about it before, but the etiquette of going to the bathroom, like where do you go backwards or frontwards over the person? Like I don't never know what to do there. Plus, like it's always, it's one of those, one of life's kind of etiquette mysteries.
And it really is like, it's a horror show regardless.
Regardless is a horror show.
It's like, do you want the front of the guy in your face
exactly.
or the back of it?
It doesn't matter.
It's a little terrifying.
And your luck is always just the worst. Who you're in between, the sandwich that you're in. So of course, you know, the things that are now developing in the airport, in the airports are these massage spas, these new oases for the stressed flyer. Have you seen these spas in the airports where you can see people, and it's the same thing as shining your shoes, really, where you're sitting up there and you're just kind of getting, you know, your shoes done, and you're looking out at everybody just kind of wheeling past you, like, well, you got to do that here, man, really? Like,
yeah, I'm always
wait.
Like, doesn't everybody have some place to get? Like, I'm always running through the airport. I'm running through the airport with the children, and
yeah.
we're running, and we're trying to make our flight. I'm amazed when I see people shopping or having their shoes done.
The guy who has time for a 30-minute massage at the airport is way too punctual. That is,
or his flight was canceled.
Actually, that's exactly right. But I think I don't know. It seems a little weird. I see the guys kind of with their knees in the thing and their head in the thing and getting
yes.
worked on. It feels very invasive. It's right next to the colonoscopies. It's.
Yeah. Which is also a nice, convenient service that they now offer
it is,
right
yeah.
there at the airport.
Because you can never be too careful.
It's so true.
Yeah.
Would you consider
therapist?
Yourself metrosexual?
Metrosexual? Is that like, I think
are you a fancy guy? Like, do you use moisturizers and hair products and grooming agents and body lotions?
Bless
and
your heart.
Gels and do you manscape?
Do I look like I manscape? I had to put tape on my shirt because my Chia Pet chest hair is popping out.
By the way.
I am a lumberjack of the highest order.
You really are. The
and
other
I don't
day,
care.
I got a glimpse of your chest hair, and I was like, it's so dense, like a forest in there.
The other day?
Ladies must run their fingers through your chest hair and get stuck for months.
Oh, my God. I, after drying off from a shower the other day,
tell us about that whole process.
I found a penny. And a He-Man eraser from when I was 12, strangely.
Is that when you got chest hair?
No, I was a late bloomer, but I bloomed, I bloomed.
Wow.
Like a delicate flower.
My husband is very hairy, and honestly, I see pictures, his Little League photos from third grade. He has a full mustache. He has a full mustache he was shaving in third grade.
So did A-Rod at that age, too, it's the baseball thing to have a little...
Well, they're talking about, how men's grooming is all the rage. Marketers, and I've noticed this myself, all of these fancy labs and skincare companies are now targeting towards men. They have products specifically made for men. You can tell that they're the men products because they're in the blue tube, as opposed to the. I guess they don't think that men are in tune enough to recognize the man products, so they put them in a blue tube.
Blue, that's for me.
Right. But anyway, so I was curious if you use any grooming products on your face, moisturizer,
creams.
Kiehl's
makes a really good, because there's caffeine in this lotion. There's a lotion that was supposed to awaken your pores, and it has caffeine, and I just, for me it wasn't the blue, it was just that I saw that it had caffeine in it, and I love.
So it's the facial fuel?
Facial fuel. Facial fuel. I fuel
from
my
the
face.
Man section of Kiehl's.
In my dark blue bottle.
That's right.
Fuel my face and my body.
There's also something called from Jack Black. Jack Black and
Jack Black has a lotion?
I didn't know that he was into making lotions, but I think it's just a Jack Black called Beard Lube. That's right. Don't you want to lube up your man with some beard lube?
Is that's for the face? That might be it.
Let me check.
I don't know what I mean. When I think of Jack Black making something with lube in the title, I don't necessarily immediately think morning face lotion. I think
it's a shave cream and skin conditioner.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, skin. Again, there's no specific. All right, I'm gonna stop right there. It's too early for that.
We got a big show today.
Yeah, it's fun.
Beth Behrs is here from the TV series Two Broke Girls.
And somebody who's had just such an extraordinary career. I'm such a big fan. Sissy Spacek, who's written a new memoir about her life.
And listen to this, everybody. Lisa Rinna is going to test our knowledge of sex with a game called the Big Fun Sexy Sex Game.
Yeah.
That's the name of it. The Big Fun Sexy Sex Game.
I wonder what it's going to be about.
It's between you and me, I'm guessing.
Yeah.
If we know four things, it'll be a miracle.
That's true.